So Geoff Keighley won't be participating in E3 this year, and what he had to say actually made a lot of sense. Let's talk about it. So the news comes from a website called VG247. Now, like I said, Geoff Keighley isn't going to be a part of E3 this year, and he had something to say in a statement on a website called GameIndustry.buzz. So he went on to say, given what has been publicly communicated about the plans for E3 2020, he doesn't feel comfortable participating in the show. This certainly wasn't an easy decision to make, but I think it's the right one for me, and I wanted fans to know before tickets go on sale, he said. Despite recent years, Keighley feels that E3 is in the middle of a transition and thinks that there's a way forward should it become more digital, global, and inclusive in its approach to connecting gamers and celebrating the industry. We're at an interesting inflection point between physical and digital events, and certainly E3 is in the middle of a transition, evolving from what was traditionally an industry trade show, he said. As for someone who attended E3 for more than 2.5 decades, there are of course a lot of emotions, but when you look at it objectively, E3 is really just the idea about uniting the industry and fans to celebrate the medium on a global scale. The future of E3 will determine based on how effective the brand is and delivering against that goal. There are two parts I want to highlight right here, especially when Geoff Keighley says that he feels that E3 is in the middle of a transition and thinks that there's a way forward should it be more digital, global, and inclusive in its approach to connecting gamers and celebrating the industry. And then the last paragraph at the bottom where he says that E3 is just an idea about uniting the industry and fans to celebrate the medium on a global scale. The future of E3 determined based on how effective the brand is at delivering against that goal. He's pretty much giving them advice. What he's doing with the Game Awards, it's a lot more relevant. He's pretty much in a safer place than E3. E3 is in a place right now where game companies don't really need E3. That's the whole thing that's going on right now. They don't really need them unless you're a small indie company. Sony has they have their press conferences. Nintendo have their Nintendo Direct. It doesn't really make sense for these major companies to spend millions of dollars just to participate in E3, where they could just live stream an event and people watch it, less money, and it's easier to get it across the entire globe, and people will still, it's not going to affect their sales, it's not going to affect anything in their business, they're still going to make the money, and they get the games out there to a bunch of people. And at the same time, you get everybody who's a Nintendo fan, or, you know, love Nintendo games, stick to that direct. You'd have a bunch of people come into E3 just to listen to different game developers talk what they don't really care about their games. They want to get to Nintendo, they want to get to Sony, they want to get to whatever company there is or whatever game developer there is. They can kind of focus on that specific game or a specific company. That's one of the things that I realized. And then now, Geoff Keighley, like I said, is in a safer space because he has the Game Awards. The Game Awards is a massive global thing. And then the thing about him when he's talking about, you know, if he feels that E3 should go full digital or whatever he was saying before, he's live streaming. Everything is just completely just digital. It's online, easily accessed, and people just watch it because he live streams the Game Award on the Game Awards and so many platforms. It's a global thing. It's a massive event, a massive, massive event. And it almost, I guess, if I was in his shoes, it feels like I'm working with my competitor. I wouldn't really want to associate myself anymore with E3 because I'm pretty much your competition right now. And I don't really see any way E3 can, like, if you guys have any ideas down in the chat, you know, let me know. I would love a conversation about this. To me, E3, without the companies on their side, E3 is pretty much just a name. Because it's not like E3 really does anything. It's just a place where game companies come to advertise their games. It's a big collaboration. I guess you call it collaboration. Basically, one building with Sony, Nintendo, all these game companies, game developers, everyone is just there with their brands and with their games to show off. If you get some people in the chat are probably a lot more knowledgeable about E3 than me. I would love to hear your comments down below. But based on my knowledge, that's pretty much what E3 is. And I just see that companies don't really see the benefit in going there anymore. And it's dying out slowly, even though it was having like a... There was a one point, I don't know if it was the year before, was it last year? Probably the year before. It was actually picking back up. I think one of the E3s recently was like one of the biggest ones since like, I think like 2004, 2005, or like earlier than that. I'm not too sure. But I definitely see where Geoff is coming from. I can just hear his sadness and his sorrow, like in this statement. He knows that they're going down, and he's hoping that they could figure something out and see what they could do to actually, you know, bring injury back and make it completely relevant. It's still relevant, but it's gonna die out because everybody's just live streaming their events, and it just doesn't make sense to spend that type of money. And he feels like, you know, he's not trying to throw shade at them. He's not trying to, like, you know, talk bad about them. He just wants the best for them. But for himself, he's looking out for himself right now. It's best for him to just completely focus on the Game Awards, focus on his, you know, stay in his lane and do his own thing. He's in a safe spot right now because he's doing something that's on a global scale. He's celebrating the Game Awards, the best games every single year. And people will tune into that. He's not trying to advertise a whole bunch of company games. It's an opportunity for him to do so if companies want to, because it's the Game Awards. And, you know, just like he revealed the new Xbox, that's awesome. That was really, really awesome. A lot of people are surprised by that. But it's not like Microsoft or Sony needs, like, a dedicated, like, place to advertise their games. Like, without E3, oh my God, how are we going to get our games out there? It's Sony. It's Microsoft. People know them. People know them. They're going to buy their games anyway. And once they're live streamer event, it's just, everything is just completely digital. Everything is just digital right now. And it's hard for companies to spend that type of money. But for Geoff Keighley, I don't feel like he's doing the wrong thing. I think he's doing the right thing. And I can feel his sympathy. I can see it in a statement. And he just wants the best for that company. He's worked with them for over the years. But he definitely sees the downfall of this. He's seen it, but like I said, the company that saw it way before everybody else was Nintendo. That's why they have the Nintendo Direct. That's why slowly they kind of came out of E3 and only had, like, a small boot, nothing really big, because they knew where the industry was going. They knew. Everyone always, you know, drops on Nintendo with their consoles. Nintendo's always in their own lane and always doing their own thing, and they know what's going on. It's a smart company. But that's pretty much what I had to say about this whole thing. Like, let me know your thoughts down below about the situation with Geoff Keighley. I don't blame him. I would just completely just focus on me and just focus on my part. It really makes no sense. It really makes no sense. I know he wouldn't say that out loud, but putting myself in his position, I'm working with my competitor. He says he's not going to participate this year. I don't think he's going to ever, like, join back in it. He will probably help on the side and probably, you know, try to help them. I don't even know, man. I just feel like he's trying not to put himself or himself associated with them. That's what it seems to me. I don't know the ins and outs of E3 exactly, but based on my outside knowledge and what I know on the internet, that's pretty much what I have to say. If you guys have anything to say down below about this topic, I would love to be educated. If you guys know a lot more stuff that I don't know about this whole thing, but I like Geoff Keighley. He's a cool dude. But all right, guys, I'll see you guys in the next one. Take it easy.